in the absence of vaccination. First of all, let's observe the progression of a disease in a naive population, meaning a population that has never been exposed to a disease-causing pathogen or vaccine. The red zone represents the spread of the disease. Infected individuals are shown in red. The characteristics of the spread of every pathogen, virus, or bacteria are unique. Coverage of 50%. Now let's look at the same situation, but this time with 50% of the population having received a vaccine. This would be termed as 50% vaccination coverage. Vaccinated individuals are circled in green. The propagation of the disease is totally different. The individuals on the right have been protected. In the end, part of the population was protected directly by the vaccine, as expected, and another part of the population was protected because it was not exposed to the disease. It is the surrounding individuals that blocked the spread of the pathogen. The phenomenon that provides this extra protection is called herd immunity. Here, the individuals protected by herd immunity appear in violet. Coverage of 80%. In the third hypothesis, the level of vaccination coverage is brought up to 80%. The spread of the disease is rapidly halted. Herd immunity is in full swing and a large part of the population is protected either directly or indirectly. This is the reasoning for high vaccination coverage. Indeed, high vaccination coverage directly protects those who can be reached by the healthcare system and indirectly protects those who are less advantaged and cannot be reached. This is why vaccines play such an important role in public health policy.